Well guys, welcome to the first official CarpFiles video, and what better way to kick things off than visiting a brand new day ticket water that's due to open very soon. We're at the amazing Boathouse Fisheries, situated about 10 minutes outside the town of Bridgnorth in Shropshire, and it is an absolute peach of the water. As you can see, I've got my partner in crime here as well. Henry the Hound is here and he's already eating sticks and all the rest of it, so there'll be more from him I'm sure later. But the house is up, the rods are out. So what we're going to do now is go and get the kettle on and then we can have a proper catch up, tell you a little bit more about the plans this place has got, how we're going to approach the water for the next 48 hours, and then a complete fishery tour as well, showing you all the swim. So yeah, it'll be a fun packed couple of days, and hopefully during that time we'll bank one of the residents that live in this amazing water. Right, let's go and get the kettle on. That looks an amazing fish. Well, that's not a bad start, is it? I suppose the rod's been out probably about an hour, if that, and we've got an absolute beautiful, stunning mirror in the net at the moment. It's got some really lovely colours on him as well. So I'm elated. He's very happy as well. So we're going to get the fish, show you what we got, and then we'll put the kettle on and have a proper catch up and tell you a little bit more about this awesome venue. So I said we're about to have a catch up and a cup of tea, but the right hand rod had different ideas, and we've been greeted with our first Boathouse fish, and it is an absolutely peachy looking mirror, very angry mirror, but have a look at him. What an absolutely beautiful, beautiful carp. I haven't weighed him yet, he's about to go on the scales in a minute, but can't ask for better than that, can you, for a start? Absolutely fantastic. I'll run you through the rigs and baits and that we were using a bit later, yeah, I thought I was with the rod there. It's a car alarm in the background, but yeah, he's an absolute cracker. More than happy to get him. I will spin around and show you the other side of this magnificent creature. We'll get him back and then we'll get the kettle on, but yeah, what a start. Yes. So here we are guys, finally had our first cup of tea of the session. Well, I started it, he finished it, I put it down, schoolboy error, and he's mopped up the lot. So thanks for that, mate. I shall be making another one and you will not be having any. But yeah, I'm over the moon to be off the mark with that lovely, lovely mirror. Just over £20 it went, £20, 8 ounces of golden brown Boathouse mirror. Absolutely elated, I really, really am. I didn't think it was going to happen so quickly for me, you know. It's we sort of arrived here and we put the drone up just to get some aerial shots, and it was quite apparent how many fish were sort of off the bottom, sort of sitting mid layers and on the surface, and it was crying out for a zig. Absolutely, you know, everything about me says you need to put a zig out. But when I arrived in the swim, I saw quite a few bubblers and fizzers, and I thought, well, there is fish on the bottom feeding. I'm not a fan of zigs personally, you know, I'd rather fish for fish on the deck with bait. That's what I opted for, and lo and behold, an hour later we've got one, so the gamble definitely paid off. In terms of the fishing, I'm keeping it really, really simple. I'll show you, I'll just bring up now the aerial shots. So my right hand rod there, that's fishing at about 50 yards just to the right hand side. That's the area we had the fish off, so it's in the shallower part of the lake. It's probably in about 5 foot of water I had that. The middle rod, literally straight out in front, I'm in about 6 foot in that one, again the same sort of distance, around the 50 yard mark. And then the left hand rod, When the sun was quite high today, there's a climbing tree just over my shoulder here. I got up the tree. When the sun was quite high, you could sort of see a couple of weed beds, and I've literally just plonked that one in between the two weed beds. And I'm fishing them all the same, you know, they're all on boilie, all on the ever faithful cell. But before I've actually catapulted the freebies out, I'm just giving them a little squirt of the smart liquid over just to sort of coat the baits themselves. Gone out there, and obviously it's done the trick after 1 hour, so it's all good. We're all happy and we're all angling, and we've got a fish under our belt, so happy days. In terms of the venue, so a little bit more about the Boathouse. Obviously I'm here fishing as a guest. I'm here to do some filming, to bring you sort of the news that there is a new day ticket water that's going to be available to fish from spring next year, 2021. The owners, John and Louise, are hoping around April time, if all goes to plans. Between now and then, there is loads of work going on. To be honest, I can't believe how much work the guys have actually done already. My good mate Alex Lister gave us a call sort of, it's probably about 2 months ago, and said, listen, this is what's happening, this is where he's working now as the fishery manager, and would I be interested in coming down doing a bit of fishing and some filming. Jumped at the chance, but the footage Alex was showing me literally just a month ago, this place was empty, it had no water in it, you know, it was drained, the fish were in a bowl in 6 foot of water while they carried on doing the work. And they've taken out, get this, over 2,500 tons of silt they've taken out of this lake. You know, they've redone all the swims, they've redone all the sort of inlets and outlets, it's all filled back up again. They've stocked it with VS fish as well, sort of supplemented the original stock, and what they've got now is an absolutely amazing fishery on their hands. Between now and when they open, obviously there's going to be facilities coming in like toilet blocks, shower blocks, so there's a lot of work still to do, but they want it absolutely bang on ready for when they open it for the Joe public, for everybody to come and fish, you know. So that's a little bit more about the venue. Tomorrow I will do a complete venue tour, so I'll go to each swim, show you what each swim looks like, so you get a better idea of if you wanted to book it for a group of your mates in, you know, next year, you've got plans for spring and summer next year, this would be a great venue to sort of have a think about. But what I'll do now, I've got a barbecue that is absolutely crying out to be lit. I'm hungry, the hound is somewhere eating, so he's hungry. So we're gonna get the barbecue lit now, kick back for the rest of the night. Hopefully one of those rods rattle off. If they do, you will be the first to know. If I don't hear anything from the alarms, I will catch you in the morning. Well, guys, I was going to speak to you in the morning, but obviously we've had an occurrence. Just gone 10:30, right, and rod's gone again, and we've got a wicked little mirror in the net at the moment. I've got the hound dog Henry keeping tabs on him at the moment, but it looks a lovely little belter again, lovely little scales on him, so yeah, I'm chuffed as. So yeah, we're going to get the mat, everything sorted, and show you what we got as our prize. I haven't weighed him yet, so we'll pop him on the scales first and then show you what we got. So let's go and get him. Here we are. So just weighed the beastie, and the little fella is just over 21 pound, 21.4 pound, but he is an absolute cracker. Once again, another wicked looking hound dog's arrived as well. Another wicked Boathouse mirror. Check him out. What an absolute cracker that one is. Made up with that one. He is an absolute belter. What a fish. And he's just as beautiful the other side as well. So what I'm going to do, I will spin the little fella around to show you the other side of him, and then we'll get him back, but I will take that all day long. And here is the other side of that beautiful creature. What a wicked, wicked carp. He is going to be a king of the lake one day, but yeah, I'm over the moon with that. Two fish in, first night, and yeah, it's going really well, isn't it, to be fair. Right, I'm going to stop me waffling on, get this one back, go and find out where the hound dog's gone, because every time I've got a carp on the net, on the mat, that's when he goes wandering. So right, I'm gonna rattle off some snaps and then get this back. But yeah, great result.
Yes.
Well, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is a very foggy morning here, but the middle rod's just come into play and we're attached to another very angry boathouse carp. So hopefully we can get this in. It's just gone, I think it's about 6:15, something like that. But it looks quite a nice fish again from the boil that's just arrived.
Going.
Well,
how's that for a result, guys? First light bite, first light fish. We've got a beautiful common sitting in the net at the moment. I only literally got that landing footage. I was doing a time lapse of the morning, and that's why the dog's in the front of the camera and all that of it. So I managed to flip it onto normal mode and we could record the landing for you. But yeah. Number three is in the net at the moment, looks another 20 pounder, so yeah, I'm over the moon. What a great way to start the day, absolutely. So as ever, we will get the mat and all the rest of it and we'll meet you there and show you the prize we got. We are away on the right hand rod now. About for first light action, obviously we've still got the common to show you, which Henry is keeping tabs on, and then hopefully we can get whatever I'm attached to now in. How's your luck? I was playing that fish then and the card was full. The camera switched off. Cannot believe it. But he's in the net. We've got two beautiful, pristine commons here from the boathouse, both waiting for their photos to be taken. So what a way to start the day. So I'll get everything sorted, get the mat sorted, and we'll get common number one out first, followed by the one that we've just landed now. Well, here we are, guys. This is the first one of the morning, and a lovely, lovely common, just shy of 22 pound this one. But have a look at that absolute cracker. Some beautiful colours on that, and yeah, what a great way to start the first morning here at the Boathouse Fisheries. Absolutely elated. Absolutely mega. All fish coming on the cell boilie. I'm fishing just some little wafters and amongst it all. I'll take you through all the rigs and that later, but for now I'm just going to sit back and enjoy cradling these beautiful, beautiful creatures. Awesome. Right, so as we said, this was number one. There's one in the net still waiting and I think he's a little bit bigger, so we'll pop this one back and we'll show you number two. $24.10 this one went, and there we go. Look at him, what an absolutely wicked, wicked common that is. Absolutely amazing. Oh, two fish at the same time in the morning, you can't beat. Awesome. Boathouse Fisheries have been very, very kind to me, that's for sure. Right, so today's antics. We're gonna be reeling the rods in very shortly. and then heading off, showing you guys all the swims here at this amazing venue. So less waffling, we'll get this lovely creature back and we'll catch up with you shortly.
That was unbelievable.
So happy. Right, thank you so much. What a morning's work. Right, we're going to reel those rods in now and then get on with this fishery tour, showing you guys some of these amazing swims that are here at the Boathouse. Thank you, my darling. Mwah. Well, we are in on the right end rod, guys. Have a fishery tour planned, but as the mist and fog was so dense this morning, I had to wait for that to lift. It's now lifted, but during that time I had to get the rods back out. I've got a beautiful common here which has just gone 23 pounds, or 23 and a half, and then literally before that I've had another two as well. A double take earlier resulted in two mid doubles, a 13 pounder, a lovely scaly one there, and then a little bit bigger than them. Check out that fish. That is an absolute pearler. Yeah, over the moon to get those two this morning. Followed the two commons we had earlier. And now all rods are out the water. And this is our up-to-date prize of 23.8. Another, when he behaves, another angry common, but another wicked looking fish. Look at that. Absolutely amazing condition again. And they fight like stinking here, something else. They literally pulled my arm off all the way in, all the way to the net. He didn't want to give up, so got another one, loving the sell. And yeah, so far we're doing something right out there, that's for sure. Right, as I said, the rods are in. We're going to pop this one back and then we're going to get finally round to the fishery tour and show you some of the amazing swims on this venue. But so far, what a result. Fish. Ah. Yes! Right guys, so finally we can get cracking on this awesome fishery tour. So the swim I've been sort of nested in for the last 24 hours, this one is called the Steps. It's centered right in the middle of the wood bank. If you're looking at it from a bird's eye view, that's where I've been sat for the last 24 hours. So we're going to pick you up now, take you down. The next swim further down from me is called Bailiffs. So let's go and have a look at that one. So here we are at the awesome Bailiff swim. This is a swim I did fancy myself, if I'm honest. Tucked away again underneath the cover of this pine wood on this side of the venue. And you've got quite a few features to go out in front of this swim. Loads of water, some absolutely awesome margins to your left and your right hand side as well. And all importantly, to that right hand side, you've got the iconic Boathouse as well. Now I was here about a week ago doing some filming, went into the Boathouse and I saw plenty of carp coming in and out, literally swimming underneath your feet. That area of the lake will hold carp, so I'll be quite happy fishing sort of a rod length off it, bit of bait, and I'm pretty sure you'll get a couple of bites off that area for sure. A lovely swim, plenty of room, one I definitely fancy myself, the beautiful Bailiffs. Well, we've arrived in swim number two of the fishery tour and we're in the amazing double swim. And as the name suggests, it's massive. It's more than adequate for two people. Commands a lot of water here as well. You get to see the whole lake itself, the iconic Boathouse in the background there. And if you like marker work, this is the swim for you. There is loads and loads of features in front of this swim. You've got depths of sort of 4 to 5 foot. In here you'll find little humps and bumps, gullies, little holes. There's all manner of stuff to go out in front of this swim, left and right. You've also got amazing margins left and right as well. To the right hand side of the swim, there's a little cutout further down the bank with some stepping stones. You can sort of step out on them, put some bait in and then cast to it from the right hand side of the swim. Lovely little feature there as well. I absolutely love this swim. I was here a week ago and I photographed and filmed the 30 pounder as well. One of the owner's mates was in, Tim. he had a lovely fish, and I was lucky enough to have the cameras here so I could photograph and film that for him. So well done that man. But once again, an awesome swim. I really do like this swim, purely because the amount of water you get. Obviously it houses two people, but again, one of the gems in this awesome fishery. So guys, on the way to the next swim, I just thought I'd stop off next to the awesome looking stepping stones baiting up area. This is to the right hand side of the double swim, and there's so many carp that do get right in here. These bushes proper overhang the lake by a good sort of 15-20 foot, so the carp do get underneath. They are all cut away, so if you do get a take, you can play the fish with your rod tips underneath the water. You'll be able to get them out that way. There are no snags that we know of in this lake. Like I say, it was all drained down, and all that sort of possibility of getting snagged up was gone in terms of trees and tree roots and things like that. So yeah, I love this feature. This is a wicked looking feature. Nugget, absolutely love that. Anyway, right, so on to the next swim. Between here and the next swim, we've got the stock ponds. Obviously that's safeguarding the future generations of the fish here at the boathouse. So the next swim on the list is the U view. So let's go and look at that. So I've arrived in the U view swim, and I'm standing at the front of the swim, or kneeling at the front of the swim with the hound, because there is so many carp here, it's unbelievable. Just to my left hand side I can see about 10 maybe 15 carp just sitting on the surface. There's some again to my right hand side as well. This swim absolutely screams carp. There's so much going on here. I think what I like about this swim mainly is that you've got access to sort of deep water and shallow water, so you've got the best of both worlds with this swim. This is a wicked little swim. I love this as well. I like how the bivvy's got its own little area. There's a path around the back out the way, so no one sort of walks through your swim as such. A lot of thoughts have gone into this one. This is the U view, but I'm sure you agree, it's an absolutely wicked looking swim. There's a little bit of weed present as well here, just to the right hand side. This is going down to the deeper part of the lake as we sort of walk down into sort of the sluice area, which is the next swim, coincidentally. But yeah, another wicked swim. What I do like about this venue is that how all the swims are very spaced out, so you're not sort of interfering with the next guy. You do get a good piece of water all to yourself. Like I say, this swim here, the left hand side, you've got a huge bay all to yourself. You've even got far margins as well on this swim. So plenty of scope to go out in this swim as well. Like I say, if you do want to get out of the sun as well, you've got probably best part of 100 foot trees right at the very back. If you need to get out of the sun, you can. The next swim along is the sluice swim, which again looks an absolute diamond one. So let's pack up the camera and go and have a look. So here we are in the next swim, a twin brother to the U view. This is sluices, and as the name suggests, just over my shoulder there, that is the sluice for the lake. Something that gets used every year. Obviously the guys here will drain the lake down, take out the fry and the smaller fish, and grade the fish they've got, so you're only fishing for absolutely beautiful, beautiful fish and some decent sized ones as well. A lovely swim. You can use that as well to feature if you want to walk out on that sluice platform. You can use that, get out to the end, pop a bit of bait out, so you've got precision baiting up and then cast from the swim over to where you've just put your freebies. You've got, again, it's a decent amount of water to yourself. You've got sort of you've got the shallows to your left hand side, so you've got depths of sort of, I'd say sort of fives and sixes to your left, and then just to the right where the sluice is, you've got depths of sort of nines, tens and elevens there. This is the deeper part of the lake, but I'm sure you agree, another awesome looking swim, one that I would be happy in without a doubt. So this sort of comes to an end this side of the bank. We'll now head over back into the wood side of the bank and head over to another beautiful, stunning place called Coots. So let's go and have a look at that swim. Here we are,
at the last swim on the tour. This is the very impressive coot swim, and look at all that you've got to go at. That is impressive. You've probably got about 80 yards of margin right up to the sluice gate. I'll stand this side, right up to the sluice gate as well. So you've got all that margin to go at. You've got open water to go at. And very importantly, do not ignore the margins, especially on this side of the bank. All the three swims on this side, so that's bailiffs, the steps, which is I'm in, and obviously this one coots. All the forest trees have overgrown the bank by about 25 foot. So everything underneath, sort of from the surface down, has been cut away. So there's no snags underneath, there's nothing the line can get attached to. Everything's been taken out. So if the fish do pick up your bait and go further inside, you can just dip your tips and play the fish back out into open water. Again, this is the deeper part of the pond. So in front of me now, you've probably got 10s and 11s, probably 12s at the, on the dam wall as well. But again, a lovely swim with plenty of scope and ample water for you. So there you go. That brings to an end the tour itself. I'm sure you agree, every swim is an absolute winner. I like them all. Every single one I've gone in, I'm like, I'll have this one, I'll go in this one. There won't be a bad draw on this place, that's for sure. So where we're at now, I'll come back up here. Obviously, this is where your rods will go. You house your bivvy up here. I'm a little bit silhouetted now because we're back in the forest. Apologies if you can't see me. But so there you go, just to recap the venue itself, maximum of 7 anglers, including the double. You will be able to sort of book this place for week exclusives. When it opens in spring 2021, I'm not sure of a date, keep your eye on the Facebook page for that. But when it opens, by then, there'll be facilities like toilet block, there'll be a shower block, and a whole host of other things. The owners here are really going to town, and this is going to be a massive feather in the cap for the Shropshire sort of carp fraternity, if you like, and what we've got to offer in Shropshire. So yeah, ladies and gentlemen, that is the Boathouse Fishery Tour. So what I'm going to do now, the angler in me is eager to get the rods back out. I've been in all day when I've been running around doing all this filming. So I'm going to get the kettle on, have something to eat, get the rods out. I'll catch up with you a little bit later and we'll go through rigs and bait I've been using, and hopefully I've got, what, 15 hours left. So I'm hoping in that time, just one more Boathouse fish will grace my net. Carp greed has definitely set in. So right, let's get back to the swim and get the rods out. So guys, that is the rods all back on their spots, ready for the night ahead. I am losing the light, unfortunately, so I'll keep it as quick as possible. I was going to run you through the rigs and bait and all the rest of it we've been using since we got here, so I'll keep it short and sweet. In terms of the bait and what we're using, so it is the ever faithful cell. Take it anywhere, it catches fish. I've never fished this place before. Usually you turn up with cell and the fish eat it. It's as simple as that. That's why I opted for. Now what I've been doing, obviously I've been catapulting the sort of 15mm cell into the area that I'm fishing on, the clear areas that I've found, and then what I've been doing is using some of this awesome new cell smart liquid, just squeezing a little bit of that into the catapult and then firing the boilies out, and obviously they're going down the water column, spreading all that liquid and the traction through the columns. So marrying that up with the hook baits. Now when I turned up in the swim, obviously we had lots of fizzers and bubblers, and now normally I'm a massive pop-up fan. I like fishing the stiff hinge rig and the multi-rig and things like that, but those fish were feeding in the silt. They're in the silt, put the bait in the silt, and that's exactly what we did with the hook bait. So I've married that up with a 15mm cell wafter and just topped it with a 12mm link wafter, just to give it sort of a snowman presentation, testing it in the side before we fire it out to make sure that the hook itself is still sitting flat on the deck. And that is the rig we've opted for. That is the simple, awesome combi German rig.
I absolutely love this rig. I've been using it now for well over 2 years, and it is my go-to bottom bait presentation now. So in terms of components, I'll just quickly run you through this. The boom section is 20 pound illusion trans khaki. To that, we've tied that Albright style to the awesome reflex camo, again in 20 pound. And then going down into the hook, a little bit of shrink tube, but the hook itself is the size 4 curved shank armor point. And that's it. And then literally, I've just got a small sort of hook ring swivel attaching the two baits and a rig stop, or a hook stop, should we say. And that's it. Little anti tangle sleeve. And job done. I'll fish that, you know, if the spot is clear, I'll fish that on a lead clip. If it's a bit choddy, obviously I'll swap over to a helicopter system. But yeah, short and simple, nice and sweet. And there we go. That is how we've been landing these fish. Obviously all three rods are back out. Fingers crossed for the night ahead. The hound's already gone to bed. He's having an early night. He's whacked. But I'm going to put the kettle on, kick back, and hopefully one of these three alarms will sing out to us. Hopefully speak to you shortly. Good morning, guys. We are in on the left hand rod. Well, whew, I hope you can hear me. I hope the camera's picking this up. Oh. So, this was the rod we put in between the two weed beds that we saw yesterday when the sun was quite high. Right now, he's put his head into those weed beds. So I'm just gonna keep the pressure on. I'm not gonna pull its head off. And when they go into beds, it's just keep a constant pressure. And I can feel him moving in it now. He is kicking. Come on, come on. You can feel him pulling through now. Come on in. Come on. Like I say, I know it was a little bit more weedy to this left-hand side, but. Oh, he's come off. Oh, what an absolute gutter. Oh, no, he's not off. It's not off. It must have gone through one weed bed and the line was still in it. And obviously the line's pinged free out of that bed and we're attached, so it's all good. Oh, from high to low, very quickly, and low to high again. He's just kiting left at the moment, but he's free from all weed at the moment, which is fantastic. He is kiting left. He's going to go right down this margin. As I said yesterday, guys, with the trees being sort of cut right underneath, now is the time to dip the tips. And I'll just play him underneath all the branches, because there's nothing underneath it. I say John, Louise and Alex have made sure there is nothing under there that the fish can get snagged up on, so I'm quite happy just playing him nice and easy. And I know he'll come back out into open water eventually. We are literally going home in a couple of hours, so it's all good to be playing this. I will say I did have couple of fish last night as well. I had he's not a bad fish. Did have a couple of fish last night as well. I had a lovely 16 pound common in. Again, the commons in here look so dark, but yeah, I was chuffed to get that one. Very nice fish. And then I followed that up with a 23 pound mirror as well. shortly after. So yeah, last night was a bit frantic as well, and he's going to go underneath the other line. Let's pick that line up. I thought it might do. Balls. Oh, I'm just going to open that bail arm right now. Just open that up. Let's get this one in. Let's get this one in. Come on, sunshine. Yes! Yes! Oh, what a result. It's taking the other rod out, but I really don't give a monkey's. That is a lovely mirror. Absolutely. Way to finish last morning and to get a bite, first light on film and all the rest of it, and we've got this lovely, lovely mirror to show you this morning. Just shy of 20 pounds, literally. I think if he'd eaten two or three more boilies, he would have been a 20. So close he was, but no doubt he will be very, very soon. He's very lively, he's had a little bit of a rest in the sling, so. But there we go, hound dogs there. But yeah, what a wicked way to finish our trip here at the awesome Boathouse Fisheries. What a session we've had. It's been a proper red letter session. They don't come around very often, and I'm just over the moon. It's happened while we were here doing the filming, that's for sure. Oh man, yes, I'm so happy. Oh, this is take, well, I've had 11 takes, and this is fish number 10. So you can't ask for more than that, but he is a wicked little mirror, that's for sure. So without further ado, guys, I just want to thank so much for watching this vlog. I hope you enjoyed it. Massive thanks goes out to the owners, John and Louise, and my good mate Alex, for inviting us down here to cradle some of these beautiful creatures and see the boathouse in all its glory. Like I say, it will be open very shortly, so keep an eye on the Facebook page of the boathouse. They'll be inundated you with updates and what things that are going on. I know there's more fish planned coming this winter as well. Can you say hello? Can you have a kiss? Can you have a kiss? But yeah. So yeah, thank you so much, guys. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you on the next one. Cheers.